A discussion on a potential deal in Washington was postponed on Monday. President Barack Obama was set to meet with congressional leaders, but the meeting was delayed to give the Senate leaders more time to resolve the conflicts surrounding the shutdown and debt limit. The delay comes as both sides were expressing optimism that a deal could be reached shortly. Joining us now from the nation's capital, our Washington, D.C. correspondent, Chris Castile. Sir, thanks for your time today. Chris, we just mentioned a potential deal in the Senate. It seems as though it could end the shutdown and extend the debt limit.
Well, that's right. The Senate leaders, Republican and Democratic leaders, appear to have reached an agreement that would reopen the government and extend the debt ceiling until early next year, you know, which would give lawmakers some time to deal with the really pressing budget issues that they have before all of this started over Obamacare, which is, you know, number one really is the sequester that they've got to deal with. A lot of people, you know, may be familiar with that term by now. It's the automatic budget cuts that went into effect in March, led to massive furloughs in the Defense Department, furloughs and cuts in other agencies. Well, you've got another round of the sequester that's supposed to kick in January, which is going to force, you know, more major cuts. And, you know, there are members of both parties who would like to see, you know, some of that funding replaced somehow. And in order to do that, they're going to have to wrestle with entitlements, you know, Medicare, maybe Social Security, cost of living increase. There's all kinds of major things that they really need to discuss, you know, with pretty pressing deadlines. Like I said, I mean, that's the next round of sequester is supposed to go into effect in January. So they're going to, we may be right back where we started, because, you know, the if passed as prologue, you know, lawmakers are going to have a hard time coming to an agreement on how to deal with these just really pressing budget issues. But be that as it may, you know, at least the hope is that they can at least reopen the government until early next year, not default, you know, on the nation's obligations, you know, later this week, and get down to serious budget talking. There's also, at least according to the Associated Press, some talk of eliminating a tax that was part of Obamacare, a reinsurance tax that, you know, is being interpreted as kind of a favor to labor unions, and also a requirement that people who get Obamacare get subsidies to purchase Obamacare next year, you know, prove that they're eligible for them.
Chris Castile, our Washington, D.C. correspondent, joining us today to talk about the big news today. And I guess the next big question, Chris, is do you think Republicans will go along with this?
Well, definitely hard to say how House Republicans are going to react to this, because, you know, they have been insistent throughout, really, even in, you know, into last week with the negotiations with President Obama about pretty significant changes to Obamacare. And, you know, I think the Senate Republicans are impatient with all of this, and they want to get moving. They're really some of the reason that this whole all the attention shifted to the Senate is because of the Republican impatience with the shutdown and the debt ceiling looming. They just want to get out of this crisis, start talking about the budget, and it's just, we'll see how the House Republicans react. Really, I mean, I think, you know, a lot of the ones who, you know, are really behind the defund Obamacare strategy aren't going to vote for much. So it's going to be up to, you know, the Speaker and the leadership team over there to decide, are we going to accept this Senate deal? And if not, you know, how far are we going to try to go to amend it? So we'll see. They don't have a lot of time. You know, the administration has said Thursday is the day that they will no longer have, you know, enough money to pay out all the payments that they need to make.
Interesting analysis, as always, from a man in Washington, Chris Castile. Sir, thanks again for your time today.
All right, you bet.
All right, that's Chris Castile. More coverage from him can be found every day in the Oklahoman as this story continues, and the latest updates as they happen on our website at newsok.com.